Hey everybody, this is your gaming girl Alexander04 and welcome back to the next chapter of House of Da Vinci 3. Now just to summarize for those of you guys who didn't understand what was going on in the previous video, Leonardo actually plans on actually using the time machine to travel back in time to the year 1465, if I remember clearly, and destroyed that original time machine before it was actually found by King Frederick, so that it doesn't actually come to the, like, when it was earlier, when it was found earlier way back in the day. So by only destroying it, we'd basically be wiping it from the face of the earth. Like, it won't really exist. So apparently, by doing that, we'll be creating an alternate timeline of such. So that's the whole point. So let's start with the next chapter. So as far as I remember, we were supposed to infiltrate Borgia's hideout as well. Yeah. On the upper floor, I was reunited with Leonardo and finally met his good friend Luca Pacioli. After talking to them, it's clear we must try to destroy the time machine. It is simply too dangerous to risk it being used by someone unworthy. See, I told you, fellas. Now it's in the hands of Ordo Eustitalis, an order that may have had virtuous beginnings, but judging by its connection to Borgia, its virtue has long since disappeared. Fortunately, the gate is damaged, and even if they were able to repair it, they can't use it without Leonardo's gloves, which were deliberately designed as a failsafe. Except that Borgia now has one of them, and it's only a matter of time before he figures out what it's good for, if he hasn't already. According to Luca's information, Borgia has a hideout in the slums but is not here at the moment, so we have a unique opportunity. The only way is to gather our wits, break in and find the glove. But I must be careful, as the place will surely be full of traps and obstacles. Yeah, knowing the guys, there's definitely no it wouldn't be a surprise, actually. Anyhow, Luca also mentioned there was a burned pub which is right next to his hideout, so we can go from... Okay, what's with the state of this door? Holy shit! Look at the state of this place, man. How long has it been staying like that, man? Yep, the floor is damaged already. It would be dangerous to walk there. So let's go back to the past to fix this whole thing. I wonder what caused this place to burn down, though. Somebody tried to destroy it and so it has to get the insurance money. Or maybe to get some more attention. Well, of course, I doubt that the concept of insurance money probably didn't exist in the Renaissance period. Eh, who cares? So it's these cute little kitties that destroyed it, that accidentally destroyed it. They knocked out this bottle of wine and also the candle that lit this ablaze. Wine is anyhow alcohol, so alcohol is highly flammable, scientifically speaking. So by extinguishing the candle, we were able to save the pub. Yay! I'm pretty sure Borgia were to show up but through this burned pub itself, or this erstwhile burned pub, I would say, then he'd be surprised at this current state. Or is there another way he can come in? A lot of thought. Anyway, let's just push through this. This must be the hideout. It wasn't easy, but I got into the house where Borgia hides in Rome. The room in which I find myself is dominated by a large map of northern Italy, which is obviously important to him. I evidently need to proceed further, but there is no straightforward way in yet. What's this? Looks like a gun of some sort. You mean an early Renaissance type machine gun? It's quite spacious, this room, but I'm not too, and a little bit, and aside from the cracks in the walls, not too shabby, I'd say. What's this behind his portrait? Ooh. Coat of arms and a letter. Dear son, I am satisfied with your leadership of the Papal Army, and I am pleased to see the diplomatic skill with which you have managed to integrate the army of the French king into your own. That will be very important in the coming days. The time for a sovereign territory ruled only by our house, the House of Borgia, is at hand. House of Borgia? As in Czar Borgia? So this letter is written by his dad. But who's his dad, though? I heard you had some trouble using gunpowder with your mercenaries. Learn from the French. What good are allies if we do not use them appropriately? Finally, the most important thing. How are the plans going that you gave to Master Leonardo? I understand it's a big job, but it's imperative that you have control over the progress of his work. I don't care how you handle it. Your father, Rodrigo de Borgia, Alexander, also known as Alexander the Sixth, Pont Max, 1496, Vatican. Alexander the Sixth. Sounds like his father was a pope, Rodrigo de Borgia, who then probably taking after the pope, becoming pope, then took on the name Alexander the Sixth, I suppose. Although I wonder what this Pont and Max mean. God only knows. Anyway, let me put this thing in it. This coat of arms. I think I know what we have to do. We have to take this bad shaped thingy, and then match it as per these symbols and see whichever fits. So let's see, there's Forli, Bologna, Pistoria, Lucca, Firenze, Prato, Imola, Bibbiena, San Marco. San what? San Marino? San Marino? Something like that. Yeah, San Marino, I guess. What else are there? Arezzo, Urbino, San Gimignano, Cesena. Wow. A lot of places written in Italian. And quite hard to understand, though. So let's start with Bologna, Imola. Firenze. Then Forli. Oh, that's San Marino. I was right. Then what else? Where we can put this? Siena? No. Oops. What's this? San Vincenzo. San Vincenzo. Okay. And where should I put this? Over here in San Marino. And then in San Gimignano. Oh, no. Then maybe San Vincenzo. And finally in this last part. Marco, Firenze, Siena. Lockpick. This can go in here. What's this? Judging by this, I feel it's something which we can use to put stamps in here. Like stamp onto something, I suppose. Yeah, I was right. Oil lamp. Wonder if this has any oil in it though. Let's see if I ignite it, what happens. Okay, those actually automatically put in cross marks on the map. My guess was correct. I've managed to mark some squares on the map, and I'm sure I'm one step closer towards discovering Borgia's secrets. Wonder how many secrets this guy keeps. So let's take this tool with a rotary handle. And I think I know where we can use it. Over here, on this machine gun. Ooh, what's this bolt? Bead screw. I think I know where we can use it. This chest over here is missing one. Right here. Yep. Metal card. And we can use it here to stamp it up. And if we go back to our journal, so these last start with these last two squares. Okay, then this one. Then this one here. Also here. And over here. Okay, I think we're done. Sorry about that, guys. Sorry for yawning. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. Okay, now with that, this is done. Let's go back up. And And my guess is that if we load this tiles onto this machine gun, then the marks on, then these stamps on it will be used as a target for the map up there. I think this is where we pump in the bolts. And we get in the gunpowder as well. Now let's load this gun with the gunpowder. All right, now we're ready to fire it. Now let's fire. All right, now we have to arrange these pipes in such a way that they are able to map, they are able to join. Cortona, Arezzo, and this is Siena and San Gimignano. What is this? A secret room. I went through the wall in a to a well-equipped lab. I never imagined Borgia as a great thinker, a strategist maybe, but an alchemist? Looking around the hideout, I found several inventions or parts of mechanisms that clearly show Leonardo created them. Perhaps he used the inventions of other scholars he employed in a similar way, or maybe it just shows the depths of his desperation. Let's check what's up there. Holy shit! Oh, that was close. I managed to get to the top floor, but only managed to escape the spinning blade of a scythe at the last moment. If I was just a little slower. Evidently, Borgia is not joking. I should proceed with extreme caution. Wait, is that? Oh yes, the glove. Finally discovered where Cesare Borgia had hidden Leonardo's glove, in a room above the alchemy lab. Unfortunately, he locked it tight. So close yet so far, people. What's this letter? 13th of April, 1502. There is something poetic about rotating scythes. The idea of using them militarily may seem cruel, but it's perfectly fascinating. Leonardo is said to have been inspired by the war machines of the Roman Empire in their designs. With the strength of the ancient Romans, they could easily conquer all of Italy. But I can only work with what I have. And the firearm Leonardo sent me, that is art. It's not much use in real combat yet, but with a little effort and minor adjustments to the gunpowder recipe, it can become my enemy's worst nightmare. One man, a single weapon, and dozens of dead in just the first few moments of battle. But what matters is what the master still hasn't sent me. I know he's still working on the gate, but he's avoiding completing it. Maybe it's time to change my approach. Perhaps he can be persuaded to be more diligent if I give him the post of chief military architect and engineer. Also, he was trying to to bribe Leonardo with a new position. What is this over here, I wonder? You have to match these things, I feel. Is that a key? Oh yes, we have the key in Grayson. I found the key in to the chest right next to it, but it is sealed in resin, of course. I'll have to find a way to get it out of there. Luckily, I have a lab at my disposal. And of course, no doubt about that. Yep, dipped in resin. What's this sticking out of the dummy? Bent wire. Well, I guess I'll just use the lab to my disposal. And I hope nobody is here yet. Good. Nobody is here. I can just work in peace. But not in slow. I can use this boiler to melt the resin somehow. I decided to put the key in an ornate furnace in the lab. I don't think the resin will be able to endure the heat. I'll have to find some suitable fuel though. Oh, we'll get it all right, we'll get it. This will go down here. What's this? Let's keep it for later. Anything can be useful for later use. A switch. And this is impure charcoal powder. I think I know where we can use the switch for. We can obtain some gunpowder and examine it. To create the fuel. Yes, as I thought, we have this flacon of gunpowder. I was able to obtain a sample of gunpowder from the weapon that was blocking the entrance to Borgia's hideout. Using the lab equipment, I'm sure I can figure out what it's made of and how to modify it to light the boiler. Of course, of course, of course. Okay, let's put it here. Now we have this container. Aha, so this is where we can actually use the metal lattice. Look at this filter though, it's really intricate. These are some alchemical symbols. So for the 4-1, it is. Oh, I think I'll see that. I'll take care of that later. That's for now. Put this and clean this charcoal powder by filtering it. So for this cross sign. This is sulfur, and this one with the black charcoal powder is carbon, and this one is the one with the only one line is nitre. I was able to obtain a sample of gunpowder and blah blah blah, and since we've got the whole combination. So if the gunpowder combination is in the gunpowder, if we look at this though, so for we have so this one is sulfur, then carbon or charcoal powder, and this is nitre, which is in a ratio of 4:5:2. And if we're supposed to do it for the boiler fuel, they should be in a ratio of sulfur 3:1, charcoal powder is 1:1, nitre is 5, which means 45 grams of sulfur, 15 grams of charcoal powder, and 75 grams of nitre. Oh well, let's get started on getting all of these things. A new letter. 5th of November, 1503. My father is dead, and it wasn't a disease, as they say. It was a clear attempt on our lives. In his case, unfortunately, successful. Wait. So Cesare Borgia's dad is dead. Without the Pope's help, my own power is dissipating. The only way forward is through the gate. I tried to keep my priorities straight, but I was a fool. I was lured by the promises of Cardinal Giuliano della Rovere. He was supposed to leave me in charge of the papal army and the order is to tell us. But right after I helped him win, he double-crossed me. Looking back, it was so obvious. He's the one who had me and my father poisoned. I swear one day he shall fall by my hand. Every time I feel desperate, my mind goes back to that map. It comforts me to revisit the victories I won as commander of the combined papal and French armies. Perhaps when I finally gain control over that gate, I can finish my work. There will be even more cities on my map, and the name of the Borgias forever recorded in history. Oh, I think I'm able to get a bit of a background of this guy. So he has something like a personal grudge against the Pope for betraying him and having his father murdered. Looks like the combinations of a safe. 4 right, 3 left, 5 right. Okay, and I know where we can use this. 4 right, 3 left, 5 right. Oh, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 right, 3 left. 0, 1, 2, 3. And 4 right. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Maybe this button is for what? Oh, it's to retry this game. Green nut, and let's take this powder flask. Let's see what this one is about. Sulfur crystal and a hook of some sort. Okay, is this ruffled paper? Oh, a letter. Esteemed Cesare de Borgia, it is my great pleasure to banish you from the Vatican. You or the men paid with your money while you still have some left are no longer welcome. The Papal Guard has strict orders to deal with you. As for your former membership in a certain order, I will offer you a friendly warning. Efforts to misuse the information you learned as a member would be unpleasant, perhaps even stressful. And given your state of health, I would advise against further involvement in these matters. After all, a lifestyle of stress and sin cost your father his life. The irony. It would be regrettable if you followed him into the depths of hell so soon. Sincerely, Pope Julius II, formerly known as Giuliano della Rovere. Also, this is the guy who betrayed him. 3rd of November, 1503, Vatican City. P.S. If you care to know my recommendation, forget everything you've been through in the last 10 years. Become a monk, find some peace. And P.P.S. It is impossible to hide from the sight of God Himself. Man. Well, now that's sad. Let's hang this hook and this weight. What's this? Some sort of symbol. Let's first crush this sulfur crystal into a fine powder. Saltpeter crystal and this strange key. Let's also turn this into a powder. Saltpeter crystal. Now let's measure as per the ratio. For sulfur, it should be about in a ratio of 3. So let's sprinkle it down to 3. Now it should weigh about 45 grams. Let's also check it out. Perfecto. Now let's do for the rest. Now for the carbon powder, charcoal powder, it should be to 1, which means a weight of 15 grams. Yeah, I can't move any more powder. Some must stay in the container. This must be about 15 grams. Yeah, this is it. 15 grams. And finally, saltpeter should be by ratio to 5, aka 75 grams. Now let's weigh that too. Perfectly accurate. Now that we have the weights checked, we can finally combine it to make the boiler fuel. Now that we fill this flask, we can finally take it. and finally put it into the boiler. Alright, it's heating up. Now let's wait. Bapre. Damn. Well, at least we've got the key though. Let's get this key, take the glove, and get the hell out of here before Borgia shows up and tries to kill me again. Oh yes, it's here. What the? A trap? God damn it! Not again! Oh man, I should have known.
The trap has sprung, Jacob. Does the situation remind you of something? I guess it's fate that the betters should have power over the rest.
You wish.
And what about those two nannies of yours, happily drinking in safety while they sent you into the lion's den? In your place, I would be upset.
You take that back.
But I am not interested in your feelings. Just listen to me and then do as you are told. It's in your own interest.
What do you want, Borgia? If you're planning on bargaining something, forget it.
Heard you already met the Viper's Tangle, calling themselves a lofty Ordo Justitialis.
You know them?
That's good. What you don't know is that they are currently led by the Pope. He is the puppet master. He would be the one profiting if they got their hands on a working time machine. And I have very personal reasons to hate Pope Julius II. I had everything. I was the most powerful man in all Italy. But fortune is a fickle mistress, or fortuna variabile. Julius II had his predecessor, and my father, Alexander VI, killed.
Oh.
He usurped the chair of St. Peter and misused the power of his station to take everything from me. My position in the order, my prestige and reputation, and even my domain. And thus, I bet everything on one last gambit.
Wow.
To obtain the time machine and reverse my destiny.
So that's their motives. This music is so beautiful though. So that's what happened. Sorry about your father though, but that doesn't excuse you for your actions, by the way. So what has it got to do with me?
I'll give you the glove you seek.
You will?
But I want something in return.
Now what?
I know you are too much of a coward to kill the Pope. Besides, I wouldn't let anyone take the pleasure from me.
Are you okay?
But I have another use for you, Giacomo.
What is it?
When my father was still alive, he appointed me to the Ordo Justitialis to find out more about the broken time machine and search for someone who could make it work again.
That's why you came to Leonardo.
Then we came to that Leonardo da Vinci of yours. And during this time, I learned something very interesting.
What? What do you want to show me?
Generation after generation of grandmasters inherited this amulet.
Wow.
When the order fell to the Pope's might, the Pope took it, and in time, he granted it to his successors, along with the power over the Ordo Justitialis.
Oh.
It's only a piece of metal, but it is a very powerful symbol. A symbol of supremacy over the Order. And I want it. And that means you, Giacomo, will get it for me. I don't care how you do it. But as I am an eternally gracious man, I'll give you a hint. In the Pope's study is a secret passage which will lead you directly to the amulet. Make one of your nannies help you. The monk was always in the Pope's good graces. He might finally be useful and maybe could even atone for getting you into this mess, don't you think?
You don't know anything about Luca, by the way.
That's your problem. As well as getting out of this cage. And don't forget, the amulet for the glove, piece for a piece. When you get it, I'll let you know where we will meet again. This is a token of my goodwill. We will see each other soon. It was a pleasure doing business with you, Giacomo.
Nannies, you don't know anything about Luca. How do they know, though? And how does he know that he's a monk? That guy is really one step ahead of us. I should have known. Intrigue is second nature to Borgia. He stayed one step ahead. He knew exactly what I was looking for. He knew about me and Leonardo and Luca. He may have even deliberately leaked information about his hiding place to lure us to Rome. God knows how long he'd been watching me, mocking me, waiting for me to spring his magnificent trap. This guy is just as crafty as anything, I must say. It's hard to say how much I can trust what he told me, but in this case, I think it was in his best interest to provide sufficient insight into the situation. Most shocking was the detail that the Pope was the one controlling the Ordo Istitialis. Borgia didn't mention how it happened, and I wasn't in a position to ask questions. Another important piece of the puzzle is the obvious hatred Borgia feels for the current Pope. According to his words, the Pope was behind his decline and the death of his father. It is true that the word of the sudden death of Rodrigo Borgia echoed around Italy, and it was rumored that it may not have been entirely natural. Also, there were people who actually had the suspicions. But the most important thing that came to light was from Cesare Borgia's monologue. And that was the fact that he is willing to trade Leonardo's glove. He wants me to break into the chambers, into the Pope's chambers, and steal the amulet that symbolizes his power over Ordo Istitialis. He said it's a mere trinket but has high symbolic value. I don't know whether to believe that, but given the situation, I have no choice but to accept the exchange for now. And what a magnificent trap he sprung indeed. And I don't understand though. He's quite a clever individual. And he showed up, and I think he showed up like quiet as a mouse as well. Anyway, let's find this key inside of this stupid jack-in-the-box puzzle. This must be the key from this jack-in-the-box. Alright, let's get out of here and I suppose I don't think we'll be able to take the key glove now, since it automatically must be locked alongside this mechanism. Well, this is it for this chapter. I'll see you guys in the next one. Adios.